Okay, hello, let me start. It's unbelievable how difficult it was to set up my laptop, but I just finished it by time. So my talk is about integrating Collabora Online with web applications. My name is Andras Timar and I work for Collabora Productivity. So this is the, I don't know, the fourth or fifth talk in this dev room about Collabora Online. So probably it's not a big news, but Collabora Online uses LibreOffice or Collabora Office under the hood for the document rendering, which is itself, I think we should stop for a moment and think about how awesome it is. Because not only we have the very rich support for different document formats, so LibreOffice is thought to be handle 100 different document formats, but it can render very complex documents as well. And you get this in the online version at no cost. So if you want multiple columns, footnotes, endnotes, sections in a text document, you can have it in online. Unlike the other online document editors where you don't get these features or you get warnings to switch to the desktop version. And I can mention in spreadsheet, Tor showed us a few great examples about conditional formatting or filters or constraints on input that is all available in online, just like on the desktop. However, it's important to know that online is not a standalone application. It doesn't implement, for example, user authentication. It doesn't implement document storage. So it's from the beginning, it was designed to be a building block of a web application. Any web application can come to mind, which can utilize a document viewer or a document editor or want to implement collaborative editing of documents. So therefore, it's very important to make this integration easy, and it's really the key to success. Because without integration, you can probably open a document from your local hard drive, but it's not a big deal because you can do this with the desktop application anyway. So, so how to experience an integration success story? The first step is to install the Collabora Online or Collabora Online Development Edition, abbreviated as CODE, on a dedicated server. You can set up the SSL for the HTTPS access. It's mandated by the protocol that we are using, but it's also good for the security in general. And then either you can install an existing integration between your document storage and online, or you can modify your web application and write this integration yourself. And then that's all. You can enjoy the success. Or maybe you have additional requirements and some modifications are needed on the online part to be able to meet those requirements. And then in the next few slides, we will go through a few of the existing integrations in alphabetical order, and I will present those additional developments that somewhere were necessary to meet those specific requirements. Okay, so the first here is Alfresco. So Alfresco is a document management system. Alfresco connector was made available by Arava. So here is the link to the GitHub. It was fully implemented in Java. And actually, they had a specific requirement. They had multiple nodes that run Collabora Online. And they needed a central monitoring system. So we implemented those monitoring system to them that in the configuration file, you can set a log server, and it collects the status messages from the individual nodes, and it the server then can aggregate this information into a central place. The next integration is eGroupware. So this was also developed by eGroupware themselves. They implemented it in PHP and JavaScript. And they also had a special integration need. Namely, they needed to print files from Firefox. So talking about printing APIs in the browser, it's basically boils down to the point then a PDF is generated and the PDF is downloaded, and that PDF is printed from the user's browser. However, unlike in Google Chrome, where there is a nice preview, in Firefox it was simply a file download, which was confusing for the users because they didn't know what to do with the downloaded file. So it was a bad user experience. So we improved this for eGroupware. We had to extend. And finally, they were happy and it worked for their users nicely. The other thing that they contributed is some tweaks to the Docker file. So they actually sent a patch to us, and it was merged and integrated, so they could use the Docker version more efficiently. The next integration is Collab. Collab developed this integration themselves. And they had a special need. They had to control the iframe from outside. So they in their web application, they have a concept called master view. And the master view can control the other views, so can close the documents for the other views. And therefore, they need to control the iframe from outside, from the web hosting web application. So therefore, we had to implement PostMessage API that can control the iframe from the outside, like closing the document or downloading or printing. We also have a Mattermost integration, which was written by Florin Chornay, Collabora. Mattermost is the next generation of IRC, or I don't know how to call that. So it's a chat program, and it has a very rich UI. You can attach files to the chat, and with this Mattermost plugin, you can open the files embedded in the chat. You can even edit it. You can collaboratively edit it with the other members in the channel. And changes are saved back to the attachment. So it actually changes the attachment in the chat history. Moodle is an e-learning software. And with the Moodle plugin, it's possible to add a live document editor into a Moodle e-learning course. So students and teachers can have an in-class collaboration on documents. Nextcloud. So Nextcloud connector was originally developed by Collabora, but now Nextcloud engineers are actively developing it and adding features. So it's implemented in PHP and JavaScript. And it's one of the oldest integrations, so we have just implemented a lot of things to meet their requirements. So one of them was that for the we have the list of active users in Collabora Online, and they wanted to have the Nextcloud avatars next to the usernames. So we implemented this as a part of the check file info API. And we also implemented creating documents from templates. And we also introduced this hosting capabilities file that the particular integration can check which features are supported by a specific Collabora Online version, because now we have many Collabora Online different versions in the wild, and also different integration versions. So they need to negotiate about the feature set they know. So OnCloud is also a very old and one of the first integrations which was initially implemented by Collabora, but now the OnCloud engineers are also contributing features to it. So one of the biggest features that we developed for the OnCloud integration was the watermarks. So it's not not the document watermark that Core presented an hour ago, but it's a watermark painted on the document tiles. So the document in the browser builds up from 256 by 256 PNG tiles, and we can add a watermark to each of them. And the problem, the OnCloud's requirement was that we shouldn't add the same watermark to all tiles, but it should be different per view. So, for example, we can include the username into this watermark, and different users can get different watermarks. So, for example, when a confidential document is collaboratively edited or viewed by many participants, and one participant makes a screenshot, we will know by the watermark who was that. So, basically, that's the one of the use cases of these per view watermarks. The PyDio integration was developed by PyDio itself. PyDio is also a document file sharing application, similar to Nextcloud and OnCloud. They had a special requirement about the access token that is used to authorize the opening of the documents. So originally we had a limited character set that could be used for the access token in order to avoid these HTTP escapes and re-escapes and double escapes and so on. But they had had to use some special characters, so we just created this improvement for them. And the last example is the roof connector, which was implemented by Soft Distribution. And for that integration, we had to improve the save as and the full screen handling of presentations, because they reported that due to some browser security settings, it didn't work as expected. So, what do you need to do if you want to create your own integration? I will just quickly go through the steps. I cannot go into the details, unfortunately, the time doesn't permit, but I would like to give you a quick overview about the architecture of this online and web app setup. So in this first screen, this is the easiest architecture of the Collabora Online and web application setup. In this, okay, maybe I can't use this, but so this is basically what we have in the browser. We have this blue box, the web application, and within that, an iframe, the online editor. So this iframe communicates through the WOPI protocol with the WOPI-like client, which provides the document rendering and editing functions. And of course, the web application communicates with web application server. And the WOPI-like client communicates with the WOPI-like host, the web application server, because it has to download the document, open it, edit it, and then it has to upload it again, which is a save operation. So these communication channels are bidirectional, naturally, which means when you set up, you need to make sure that your browser can see the WOPI-like client and vice versa, and also with the web application, and also those two servers have to see each other all the time. So it poses some problems when you have firewalls, proxies, high availability setup, and so on. So this is a different different presentation, so it's a topic on its own, how to do this properly. But for a simple demo, it's of course not a problem. So we need to talk a few words about this WOPI protocol or WOPI-like protocol. So WOPI is an abbreviation of a web application open platform interface. So this protocol is used to exchange documents and data between web applications, so it's just suitable for this case. And it's an open standard. You can read the documentation, and Collabora Online implemented parts of that standard. Also, it extended some maybe incompatible or by their own ways, so we call it WOPI-like because it's not WOPI, but very similar. So the theory, in theory, it's it follows this standard. So the next step, when you implement your integration, is to implement only three REST endpoints. So one is for downloading the file, one is for uploading the file. So this sounds quite obvious. And we have a third one, the check file info, which provides information about the file. It provides, for example, the file name, the file size. There are some parts that are mandated, but there are also a lot of extensions that I will show you later. So this is a really useful. This we can put a lot of information into this check file info. So the next problem is the authorization problem. So we implemented this by a security token. So obviously you authenticate the user into the web application, but when you want to open a file, the WOPI-like client, the Collabora Online, wants to download this file from the web application, so it has to authenticate itself again. But naturally we don't want to ask for the user credentials every time. So this is why we have this security token, which is generated from the user authentication data and from the file data. But it's recommended to create it that way, that it's not, it shouldn't be possible to guess user or document related information from that. The next part is to write a JavaScript code to actually embed the iframe into the web application. And this iframe will contain the online editor. So, and for this iframe initialization, first you have to ask the server about this so-called discovery XML, which is also part of the WOPI protocol, which tells you for which document format, which parameters should be passed to this iframe. Because in theory, it's possible that different document formats are served by different servers. Or this discovery XML tells the web application which document formats are supported in the first place. Okay, so when you create this integration, we have seen many attempts and many problems. So now we have a best, so-called best practice, or I don't know how to call that. So recommended steps that you should follow. So you shouldn't, you probably wouldn't want to write the whole integration in one step. So the first step would be to just write a minimal application that returns a hello world message. Then you implement a check file info endpoint, and then you can actually see something in your iframe, this hello world HTML, minimal HTML document. And then you can go to and implement the access token handling and implement the save, the update REST endpoint, and so on. So this is the recommended way to develop. So if you need to tweak the functionality, you have you can of course change the source code, but there are other options. Because as I mentioned, we have APIs for changing the online user interface as it was done for the Collab integration. So with this PostMessage API, you can add buttons, you can hide menu items, you can hide buttons. And when you add buttons, you can also add the the code, what happens when the user is pressing it. So for all of these possibilities, you can see the reference documentation in the source code. Okay, so this PostMessage API, which is also part of the WOPI standard, it's a method, it's a communication channel between the iframe and the integration. And from the integration, we only require that it sends a host post message ready message, and then you can use this API. Then the other thing, we have the check file info extensions. I wouldn't read them all, but we also have them on in the source code. The last line, I gave the link to the GitHub mirror, so you can read it there. But with this check file info, for example, you can disable printing, saving, exporting, or disable the copy paste, or with the user extra info, you can pass the avatar of the user. With the watermark text, you can pass a tile watermark, and so on. So it's very well worth to explore these options. So as a conclusion message is the partner with Collabora, because we are here to help you, and when you have specific needs, then we can prioritize them. And actually, all of these features were developed by or with the help of our partners, who actually sell the product, and we are very thankful to them for this. And yeah, just a few other things that came from these partner contributions. For example, the better PDF rendering in the online using the PDFium library, the library that Chrome uses. So we don't import the PDF by LibreOffice Draw, which broke the PDF into individual shapes and tried to render them individually. Rather, we import it as a bitmap, and it gives higher fidelity. Or I can mention this template source feature that was originally developed for Nextcloud, but available for all. So you can set a template, and when you create a new document, you can select the template, and it will be the new document in the online version will be created with that template. Okay, so that was all from me. Thank you for listening. And if you have any questions, well, I'm probably run out of time, but you can find me after on and or Candy or Michael or
half minutes for questions.
Any questions? Okay, thank you.